Glucagon is a hormone synthesized in the pancreas, and it increases blood glucose concentration. It also inhibits gastric and pancreatic secretions. This may increase heart rate and cardiac output and decrease blood pressure, and it increases overall metabolic rate. This medication is quickly destroyed by the GI tract, so it's not effective when taken orally. The maximum hyperglycemic activity occurs within 30 minutes of administration and disappears after 1 to 2 hours. Also, relaxation of smooth muscle occurs within 8 to 10 minutes and persists for up to a half an hour. The half-life of the medication in the system is 3 to 10 minutes. It's degraded in the liver and the kidneys. Indications for the administration of this medication: unconscious patients who are highly suspected of being hypoglycemic, where IV access is unobtainable, and also altered mental status combative patients where IV access is unobtainable due to venous collapse or altered mental status and suspected hypoglycemic status. Contraindications: known hypersensitivity to glucagon. Adverse effects commonly seen include nausea and vomiting. Glucagon will only work, however, if the liver has sufficient glycogen stores in place to convert to glucose. So glucagon may not be effective in all cases. Dose ranges for patients with suspected hypoglycemia without IV access: administer 1 milligram glucagon IM for adult patients, and for pediatric patients, 25 to 40 kilograms, administer 1 milligram IM, maximum total dose of 3 milligrams, and for patients less than 25 kilograms, 0.5 milligrams IM dose, maximum total dose of 3 milligrams. For patients with suspected beta blocker overdose, the adult administration of 1 milligram IV push every 5 minutes is indicated, and for pediatric patients, administer every 5 minutes 1 milligram IV push for patients 25 to 40 kilograms with a maximum total dose of 3 milligrams, and pediatric patients less than 25 kilograms should receive 0.5 milligrams IV push to a maximum total of 3 milligrams.